Hello my beautiful subscribers. Today I will teach you how to create the scene made in modern 3D design. Let's start by creating a plane. Subdivide it into a large amount of geometry. Now create a stand, place it in the center of the plane. We edit the plane so as to create cavities at equal distances from each other. Copy the stands and place them on the plane. Create additional cavities. Set up and adjust the camera. Ideally, you want a big focal length. You can also use orthographic display mode. Let's start creating and arranging the objects in the scene. The first object I will create will be this pyramid. Copy the stand and shrink it. Add the bevel modifier and complete the pyramid. Now create this colorful cube. Create a cube and subdivide it in edit mode. In the future, when I get to the materials, we will turn it into what we need. The next object is a cluster of glass balls, but for now we will only create the object. Glass materials later. My favorite objects in the scene are these translucent ribbons, quite complex. Create a plane and increase the amount of geometry. Add the displace modifier, create a texture, and adjust it like I did. Create an empty object. In the displace modifier, select it for the texture coordinates. Duplicate the ribbons and you're done. Blender logo on a stand that is in the middle of the scene. I created the logo in the last tutorial. The link is in the description. Let's create objects for the particle system. Create any objects and place them outside the camera's field of view, for example under a plane. Select the plane, then select the bottom of these recesses. Press Shift plus D, press P to separate the geometry. Lift this up. Remove only the faces. Create a particle system. In the render tab, select a collection with pre-created objects to generate them from the previously created grid. Let's move on to the lighting of the scene. It's very complex, I would say interestingly complex. Create a cube and stretch it out to length. Position it roughly on the edge of the scene. And duplicate it on different sides of the scene. This way, our scene will become more voluminous. In the material settings of the previously created meshes, create an emission shader and adjust the lighting. Use different colors of light as desired. The scene still seems quite dark. Fix this by creating light sources. Place them above or below the objects. As you can see, there are shadow patterns in the original render. In a previous tutorial, I already showed you how to make them. Let me show you again. We need a spotlight. On the Object Data Properties tab, click Use Nodes. In the Shader Editor, create and merge these nodes. Repeat after me. Let's create a material like a grid pattern for the plane. Now let's create the material for the stands. We'll use pointiness from the geometry node. The creation of materials for objects will start in a clockwise direction. So let's start with the pyramid. Let's move on to the glass balls. Let's create materials for colorful rebounds. For the cube, we will use the functionality of the material slots. Create three slots and assign a different color to each material. In edit mode, select multiple faces, then select a slot and click assign. This will allow you to apply a specific material to a specific geometry. Repeat this as many times as necessary. I forgot about the particle material. It is absolutely identical to the material for the logo. I created it in the last tutorial. Let me show it to you. Create a glow in the recesses. Create a second slot on the plane. Select these faces, press assign, create a material with the emission shader. You can add extra lighting, fix some things, adjust the power of emission shaders, and just try to replace the objects. Create beautiful renders and share them with me in the comments. Thanks for watching. Bye.